everyone. My name is Amax with the Facts. You are now watching the AWF series, and of course, we make the unknown
known.
That's right. And right here, I'm here at Taipei, Taiwan, at the Taipei Main Station. And if you want to see more future interviews about the foreign community here in Taiwan, press that subscribe button, press that like button, and also leave a comment of what you think about this interview for here today. But I'm not here to talk about that. Sitting to my right, he goes by the name of Mr.
Fernando Ramos.
All right, Mr. Fernando, how are you?
I'm doing great.
All right. So, Mr. Fernando, may you please tell your viewers who you are and what you're all about?
Okay, my name is Fernando Ramos. I come from Honduras. Right now, I'm working as a business development manager in Suntec, Taiwan. It's a company that sells drugs, specifically pharmaceutical products. I'm also the president of the Honduran Association in Taiwan, and I also do a couple of volunteer jobs as well.
All right. Now, guys, when he says drugs, he already clarified that, so don't worry. It's not the type of drugs everyone thinks about, so relax. You have to like, be more clarification nowadays.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. Now, basically, how I discovered Fernando, we were in a business event that had like a whole collection of foreigners or people who were passionate to build their own businesses here in Taiwan. But most of them are English teachers, and they wanted to find a way to leave their English teaching job.
Correct.
Now, you said that you also done some tutoring. May you also explain that, and also what were the challenges, what were the benefits of being a tutor here in Taiwan?
Well, I used to do that when I was still in college. I came here to pursue a master's degree. Mm-hmm. And while I was studying my master's, of course, I went a little bit into tutoring because the money is very good. And I think that for challenges, I didn't have so many. But I think that one of the advantages that I had is that you manage your own time, which is a little different than working a full-time job, because you can actually decide when you want to do it. You can say no, you can use your time for whatever you want. Like, and while you're having a full-time job, you actually cannot do that. So in that way, I think that when you compare them, like, I think that freedom is an aspect in consideration, and also the pay is higher, of course.
Oh, nice. All right, so the reason why I wanted to interview Fernando, there was a Q&A section, and Fernando, he stood up, and he made some very strong statements and also strong opinions here about his stay here in Taiwan. And Fernando, I want you to share that same honesty. What are your pure thoughts? What are the challenges and the benefits of living in Taiwan as a foreigner? As a whole, in your own opinion. Here we go.
Well, I think that regarding benefits, especially, after I come from a country like Honduras, I think that safety will be one of the biggest benefits that we have. I think that Taiwan is a very safe country. You can walk at any time through any neighborhood and nothing is gonna happen to you. And that's something that, you know, I value a lot. Mm-hmm. I think that the insurance that they have, like the medical insurance, is also another advantage. I have never seen or, you know, heard of something like as good as that, where, you know, practically everything is covered and like the fees are not so high. I think that's something that a lot of countries should imitate, and that's a very good thing. Mm-hmm. Another advantage that I think is, like, for traveling it's a very convenient place to live. I think that, you know, it's cheap to travel. I think that you also get exposed to a lot of different cultures, because there's a lot of people that come here to study and, you know, to work as well. So I think that it's a very good place to expand your mind. I love this country, but I do think that there are some things that need to be improved. One of the things that I was talking about during the Q&A in the events where we met, that's an event held by All Hands Taiwan, which is one of the projects that I'm also supporting. And if you have time, you should go check it out. There's a lot of information there. You can find some interesting articles. And also there's a tab with resources for people that is looking for jobs, because that's the main focus of this initiative, that is helping people to find jobs or helping people that are teaching English to move into professional jobs if they want to pursue something different. So make sure to check that out. The problems that I think that we have, that Taiwan has, is that there is not enough information available for foreigners regarding the procedures, the hiring procedures, the work permit procedures. I think that we have seen, and actually I just wrote like an op-ed for a newspaper called Taipei Times, which is gonna be published very soon.
Nice.
And in which I was talking specifically about that Taiwan has made a lot of efforts to like retain and recruit like international talent. just now, like in November, they approved a law, or they made some modifications to the law so that international students that graduated here can stay for over a year.
Okay.
And they had made like another changes to the work permit system so that it's easier for people that wants to stay here working.
Wow.
That was approved last year. And like, but the problem is that even though they changed the law to make it more accessible, a lot of people don't know how it works.
Right.
And it's not only the students, it's not only the professionals that are looking for jobs that don't know how it works and don't know how to find information, but companies as well. And that's a big problem. I worked for two different companies in Taiwan, and I did an internship for a third one in the 4 years that I've been here.
Mm-hmm.
And in the last two, in the companies that I worked, they didn't really understood how the process worked. So, for example, when I went to my previous job, like the job that I have right now,
right,
they didn't really know that there was a difference between people that had actually graduated from here, which is a table that you have to get 70 points from to get a work permit, from the people that comes from my side that has never studied in Taiwan, that they need to get a salary of above 48,000 NT. So actually they were worried about that because like they were like, okay, we need to pay you this amount. And I was like, but you can use the table, which is a different system. And they had no idea about it. And I ended up having to explain to the HR how it worked. And another experience that I had, one of my friends, who's working also for a company in Taiwan, he called me and asked me to explain him because the HR from his company told him that he had to start the process, which is not how it works. Like,
right,
companies need to contact the Ministry of Labor to get the work permits.
Right.
But they don't know that. So what I'm trying to say with this is that Taiwan needs to, you know, attack this problem because that makes the companies that might be interested into hiring foreigners get scared of going through that process because they don't know how to do it and they think that it's too complicated, so they will just rather not hire a foreign that they might need and that they might want.
Right.
So I think that that's one of the problems that need to be addressed. Like, definitely, that's one of the problems that needs to be addressed. And another thing is that because of the same problem that they have, that, you know, with the lack of knowledge of how their own labor laws work, there's a lot of exploitation. I've heard from many of my friends, you know, this is a very, like, recurring theme that, you know, there's always, like, extra time that doesn't get paid. That the Taiwanese bosses expect you to behave in a certain way, or that they expect you to, you know, work overtime and really not ask payment for it. And if you do, they will think that you're lazy. That's something that, you know, it's kind of a big issue. In some other cases, like when there's, you know, when the people wants to quit, I was hearing from one of my friends the other day that they were trying to withhold some payment from her, like the last month of payment, because she was gonna quit, when that's obviously not according to the law. You know, that's something
right.
that the companies are not supposed to do. You're not supposed to be punished for leaving a company. There are some regulations. You do need to let them know like ahead of time. That depends on how long have you been working. But that doesn't mean that besides that, they can push that, you know, farther.
Right.
And which is something that companies sometimes try to do. And they, I'm not exactly sure if they do it because they don't know how it works, or they know how it works, but they just want to take advantage of the fact that a foreign might not know how it works, to kind of like scare them or pressure them into things. And I think that that's something that also needs to be addressed.
Wow. See, I told you before, this is why I brought the guy in the video.
Well, I'm a lawyer. I just want to, you know, guys, let you know that I know the law, and I actually read like Taiwanese labor law a lot, because the same thing happened to me. Like, when you don't know your rights, it's very easy for someone else to take advantage of you.
Right.
So that's another thing that I will suggest you to check. The Ministry of Labor does have the labor regulations, at least a summary of the more important ones in English. That's something that I will advise anyone who's working in Taiwan or is looking for jobs in Taiwan to go and read, because it will be very helpful to know what your rights are, so that kind of situations don't happen to you. Or if it happened, at least you will know how to defend yourself.
All right. Well, you heard it from the master here. We'll be right back.